My name is Christian. I'm a joiner here in the Miniature Wonderland 14 years. The Miniature Wonderland is the biggest model exhibition in the world. It's amazing. We start with a team around about from 50 people. Now we are 400 people. 1 million people comes every year to visit us. It's amazing. That's why I'm working here. I love it. As a joiner, when you build something for a bedroom, only 2 people see what you have built. And here comes 1 million people. Everybody get out with a smile, and that's so cool. I love it. Our scale is between 1 to 87 to 1 to 120. So in one ride, we have around about 300 LEDs. That's unbelievable. So we have airplanes who can fly, many cars who can drive. It's amazing.
I'm Mikey, I'm 30 years old. I'm working in the Wonderland for 5 years now. All of us are really proud to work here. I'm a carpenter. I thought I would love to work more creative, so I studied industrial design. I started to work here because it's design model building. Tools that I normally use in my workflow are at first computer stuff, Rhinoceros CHD software, and then we go into milling with a big CNC mill, and afterwards do a little handwork with a circular saw and stuff. In the moment I'm working on the fanfare. We build a huge new fanfare. We have already one, but it's kind of oldish and we want to replace it. There I do some under construction work, playing the table. Process is a little bit complicated because in this fanfare stuff it's mostly board model kits, so it's really hard to say how big these exactly are, and so we have to be really like free in our process in placing stuff.
We often build with photos. We have the problem that we have not enough place, so we have to say okay, we only can build this building or this building. You can see here some pictures. This is a fanfare in Hamburg. So we take a lot of photos, and then it comes and draw it on the platform, and then we do it in Rhino. So it's easier to plan for us in 3D.
So this is the point where the origin is in the process. So we can cut out directly and place it just in time. So we have a really, really kind of free process to make things, finish things and place them afterwards. And that's really good to be creative. In the fanfare, we make like a pocket, set things flush. They have a kind of aluminum base plate. So it's easy to take them out, take them to the workbench and repair them or something. So we had to do a lot of planning, and now we can just work in time. If something's ready, I can take it, measure it out, just make the pocket and yeah.
Yeah, this is actually the fanfare part, the table you can see down there. This is the planning I made for the table, and all these parts I have made on the CNC mill. This part, for example, and the cutouts for the attractions are these. Every of this thing have its own aluminum plate, so we can just take it out. I have used the origin to just make these cutouts exactly. It's quite good to use a computer-based hand tool to make these cutouts. Normally, we make like this plate on the CNC mill and can see the final result real life just at the end. Now we have opportunity to make these cutouts in the process and have a directly like visual feedback or something what we're working on. So I was really happy to see innovation in the carpentry work. It's not normal to have innovations like this. For me, different in working here because I just did modeling stuff, and nowadays I do construction stuff, so I think having a tool like this is more interesting for me nowadays than in the past. It's just normal to try to reach another level in accuracy or in detail working for us, because I think it's challenging, and yeah, we try to getting better and better and better.
From the start to the end, we often need 4 years. First plan, drawing, plan for the trains, and then we plan the under construction. So and then comes every people from the electric comes on. It says, yes, I want to have this way for my cable. So from month to month, more people come to the project. So in Monaco, we have, I think, 8 people who draw the buildings. And in the exhibition, only 5 people who will sit modeling the mountains, because you have no place. When I work here, no one has a place to work with me in this area. So Monaco is the first one we tour with Rhino complete, because it's easier. It's so big and so many buildings. We never have built so many buildings. We want to build 100%. So that's when people come from Monaco, they visit us and see their building, they can say, hey, that's my building, that's my house. So that is for us. Here's the origin, perfect. We can make it on the place where we work. Often we need a CNC, but our CNC is more for plastic and for buildings. So it is perfect for me as a joiner. I can make everything here. Normally we're building, we don't move it. You have no chance. I'm so happy with this origin because I can make little things alone. I draw it, put it on the machine and start it. So that's so cool. And this machine works with millimeters. It's perfect because I don't need templates. I love the machine.
In the big machine, I would like to say that we make 90% of the big machine and 10% on the origin. Often this is so that the last 10% you need for the 100%. So I think the origin is a nice extra tool for us in the joinery.
I'm Tino. So we want to build a new road because we have a lot of streets and this is another level. So we need to shape a road from this level to this level.
Looks really good. Perfect. If I have the possibility to take this, I always take this because you can take your curves and lines directly from a CAD and work on every place where you have a flat area. You need no other templates and can directly work where you want. Really first I thought that's a fake, but it's really cool and crazy.
The most important difference between this machine and the origin is maybe that you can't bring this one to the construction site and work. You have to make a lot of planning to get an actual result out of it. Especially making woodwork is kind of a one shot. If it doesn't fit, you have to start all over. And yeah, with the origin, you can just feel like to make a pocket, a hole, something. You just say, okay, I do it now, and this, yeah. Kind of miracle that the shaper tool will find itself, and when I use it, it will find the pockets and holes I made in the past, and kind of a miracle to me. This is really great. I can make some recuttings or change depths and stuff. I think the main point is that you can work with the origin on the construction site itself, and with this, yeah, you don't.
Often we build the exhibition and then I see, okay, I need a new street and the CNC is full. I have to wait. So that's a big problem. And with the origin, I have the best machine that I can make by myself. You only need the tape, scan it, and I can work with the machine. So that's really cool. We need something detailed. Origin is the next step for me. You can make it at the place where you build.
I think the most benefit of origin is have a really, really fast process in doing small work. That's really good. You can draw a little bit on it if you want to make a hole in something or a pocket or even some writing. So yeah, that's really great.
Really easy for me as a joiner to say, cool, I have my little CNC for me. The computer helps you cut on the line perfectly. Sometimes you need only a hole, which must be perfect. So on this machine you can cut and you can test it and you can come back with the machine and saw on the display, okay, here's the hole. Yes, we make it a little bit bigger. You can never do with your hand only. So it's a really cool tool for the rest of the joinery. Sometimes I love my job and sometimes it trains, I hate it. But when you see the smile on the guest's face, you know that was the right way to work here. And yes, with every new land, we have more and more ideas what we can do, and that's amazing. And that's why I love my job here.
A lot of people ask me this question. I never can describe it. Always depending on the people which are asking, and every time it's different about the description about this place. Yeah, it's just crazy people doing crazy things together. That's all I can say.